Hey, we're ready.
All right, here we are. Chuck and Pugs today. We got Mr. Rob Barraco here. He's a keyboard player extraordinaire. Now, Mr. Barraco, I know you've had quite an interesting career.
I have.
You have. Now, can you tell us exactly what you've done in your past and you're so proud of as far as career goals?
I've done a lot of things I'm not proud of.
Okay.
Let's see. What have I done? I guess the first big break I ever had was I started playing the music for the Cosby Show back in the 80s when the Cosby Show was in its infancy.
When it was beginning.
And we just got approached by this guy who turned out to be the music producer of the show. And he's like, "Do you want to play on a TV show?" We were like, "Yeah, why?" It's the Cosby Show. I said, "Bill Cosby?" He goes, "Yeah." He's like, "Well, all right. So he gives us his card. We figure we'd never hear from him again.
Okay.
Sure enough, the next week he called us and we ended up in the studio. And then 9 years later, we did the whole run of the show.
So still playing on the show.
Yeah.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, that sounds like quite a milestone for
it. Was great. It was really cool, but it was one of the most frustrating gigs that you can have as a musician because you're sitting in a studio with arguably the best New York studio musicians or the best studio musicians in the world.
That's it.
And playing for 4 seconds at a time.
Like,
okay guys, one, two, three. Okay guys, page two. It's like, and then, okay guys, we have to sync to tape now. Why don't you take 5-10 minutes? And then all of a sudden a spontaneous jam would break out and it started getting really good. Oh, guys, settle down now. So, but
awesome.
And that led, we had a guest keyboard player on one time and he ended up calling me up a couple months later and asked me if I wanted to go on tour with Freddie Jackson, the R&B musician, "You are my lady."
Okay.
That guy.
All right. I hear you.
So I ended up being the only white musician in the band. I was a token whitey. Which was kind of cool because I grew up in a town called Westbury on Long Island, New York, and it was a really integrated town. So, I was used to that. It's cool, But what I wasn't used to was being on a tour bus with all these cats from Harlem.
No, I can understand your feelings.
So,
right.
As the tour progressed, I started picking up the lingo, which they call uptown, and they talk in like half sentences and shit. It was when diss became like a real thing. Like, "Yo, man, don't diss me." So we're hanging out one day backstage at some show, and I was trying to talk to the drummer and the bass player, and they just kind of like blew me off. Like started walking away. I went, "Yo, don't you diss me?" And they turned around, going, "Rob Duel, you're my man." And then I became Rob Duel Salam Baraka, the honorary black man.
I see what you're saying. I understand exactly where you're going with that.
So it was kind of cool, So I when I got home from tour, that's the way I was talking.
I hear you.
My ex-wife looked at me and she goes, "Who are you?"
She didn't know the man that came off that bus, did she? Now I got another question for you. As a performer, what would be your favorite song to play for an audience? Grateful Dead or not grateful? What would be your?
It's got to be Dark Star because it's so open-ended and you really can just play. You can play stream of consciousness playing anything that comes in your head. As long as you're group mind and all that. But still, it's so open-ended that you can take it wherever it wants to go.
I understand.
And that to me is great because there's no blueprint.
There's no ending, there's no beginning.
Yeah, it just does its thing. I mean, there are some versions, there's a version that I really like, it's a real freeform one. I think it's December 3rd, 73.
Okay.
And it just kind of melts in. There's no beginning, there's no da-da-da-da. And it goes to all these crazy cool
places. It kind of creates itself.
And I like that because I consider myself a jazz aficionado.
I agree.
Mr. Snobby Jazz Guy here.
That's okay.
But, that's what I aspire to. More open-ended, out there stuff.
Well, Rob, thank you for your time. It's been great talking to you.
My pleasure.
Yes, sir. Thank you.
Keep on trucking.
Thank you. Keep on trucking.